Hey, what's up, everybody? I'm Ludric Relsey Cooper. I am an author, I'm a podcaster. Most importantly, I am a wedding videographer, and you're watching the Wedding Videographer docuseries broadcasted to you live here on Instagram. I got a feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. A feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be. Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome back to another episode of the Wedding Videographer docuseries broadcasted to you here on Instagram, also known as IGTV. I want to say thank you for everyone who checked out last week's episode. As you know, last week was about me, how I got into wedding videography, how I took on a hiatus, how I came back, just all the ins and outs of being a wedding videographer from my perspective. But this episode, we're going to hear from someone else's perspective. A young man by the name of PJ Manderville. He has his own company called Color Star Media out of Charlotte, North Carolina. He's a podcaster also. So definitely you guys need to tune in to this week's episode. Again, I want to thank you again for tuning in to the Wedding Videographer docuseries here on Instagram.
Videography. What I decided to do is go to school for videography. I went to Claflin University. And from there, I just developed a love for videography across different spectrums, not just from a, recording track meets, et cetera, but also television, also creating TV, TV shows or music videos, et cetera. And a lot of people would tell me, or other videographers would tell me, say, hey, look here, you know, this is a field that a lot of videographers usually get into is weddings. And I didn't really think about it. I didn't think about that being something that I would do. But once I tried it, I understood that I had to learn up under somebody, because it's a process. It's not just you go and record a wedding. Like, you have to know what shots to get, you know, close-ups, mid-range, and so forth. And throughout the day, you have different various parts of the day that you would have to record certain things to put it all together when it's time to edit. So upon knowing that, I got in touch with someone out of Columbia, South Carolina, and I learned under him. And the first time that I recorded with him, he said, you know what, you're probably about 3 to 4 years out. I said, 3 or 4 years out for what? He meant, like, basically saying that I wasn't ready, you know, and I didn't want to accept that, because, you know, I guess when you come from a certain, you know, part, you come from a certain school or area where you're praised a lot, et cetera, for what you do, and you're trying to reach various different levels, you're not used to being told that you need to work on this or work on that. Especially you wanting to jump into business, you're like, okay, well, I'm the head honcho. I'm the head, you know, I'm the CEO. Like, you know, I'm good at this, you know. So to hear that was disheartening, but looking back on it, I'm very thankful for it. That helped me to propel myself into wedding videography by me understanding that, you know, I had to be humbled, and be humble as far as learning the different parts of what's important. My very first camera was a Canon T2i. As a matter of fact, no, it may have been the Sony FX7. It was a bigger camera. You could kind of put it on your shoulder, but you still look a little crazy. But at the same time, you can hold it in your hand, and it, you know, it looks pretty decent that way. But it was just a mid-size range camera, crossbreed between a camera that you would probably see on a movie set and a person who use a DSLR, a small handheld camera. And then I got something else. I can't remember. Basically, I got a bang for my buck. It's like, hey, I sold that, so I got that plus a lens, et cetera. But it was something that I had to transition from, because all I knew was bigger camcorders from college. That's what we learned from a TV style approach. So going into the DSLR range, which is basically a lot of videographers at that time frame between 2009, 2010, a lot of videographers transition to what we call DSLRs or mirrorless cameras later on. So I'm thankful to be a part of both eras. I shoot with primarily Panasonic and Sony's. Now, Sony mirrorless cameras, Sony A7S, A7S2, Panasonic GH4, GH5. So I bring in a contractor, and normally I like to be very cohesive. So what we'll do is I will help them out on their weddings and vice versa, so that we are constantly growing together and getting better together. So contracting, you know how it goes. You're paying percentage of the price of what you get, and you know they'll help you out maybe that full day or pretty much all of the day. So very thankful for my contractors. I would go back and forth between actually doing a docu style. I would have a lot of audio, you know, a lot of the bride or the groom talking about their experiences together before time, before the day of tying the knot or before getting engaged, et cetera. And then I'm transition into more of a cinematic style fully, like 100%. And I prefer cinematic. It gives me ample opportunity to really show more of the day. Now, if it's suggested that they want to go that route where they want to add in a lot of audio bites and they want to express their love on camera, then no problem with that. We can get that done as well.
I'm going to say it again in front of all our loved ones. I thank God for setting those events so that I could meet you and for those events to lead us to be here today and for the rest of our lives.
I wouldn't say recently I have been doing this. Maybe a couple of years ago, I used to do this constantly, which is kind of see how they prepare for the day, what kind of equipment would they bring. And because reason why I wanted to do that, because I wanted to bring every single piece of equipment that I had. And, you know, I don't drive a van. I don't drive a truck. You know, I want to make sure I have, you know, just what I need. I don't need to be bringing all this, you know, little odds and ends and accessories if I don't need to bring them. So what I would do is I would make sure I would, you know, learn tutorials from others consisting around the day as to what they bring and, you know, throughout the day, what kind of equipment are they tagging along in their hands. And that's very important too, because you can carry around so much, you carry around so much equipment. What happens is you can get wore down for a 10-hour period. So basically what I do is I would have 2-minute clips, maybe a 1-minute clip. I'll have a extended version and a short version. I have a 1-minute clip like for Instagram. And then also I can go to IGTV and do a longer one, but I found that the shorter clips do well and compounding the best of the best within 1 minute. And as you know, or many videographers know, or video editors know, as when you're editing, what happens is it gets even harder once you're trying to scrunch it down, because you're taking, 10 hours of footage. You know, a lot of customers may not understand that, but it can get even crazier. So they're like, oh, 1 minute, why is it, why is it this amount of it? But that's what comes with it. And you have so much footage to compound it down. Now, as far as the marketing side of that is doing IG, sponsored ads, Facebook ads, etc., and making sure I'm getting myself out there, not only from a local perspective, but from a national perspective, making sure that I can travel as well. So we like to travel. I've been to West Virginia. I've been to, Florida. I've been to Charleston, and I live in Charlotte. So, we want to make sure that when we're marketing, to make sure that we're getting ourselves out there in a way that is on a national scale, not so much just local.
Well, all right, y'all, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you again for tuning in to this week's episode of the Wedding Videographer Docuseries. I hope you guys learned something new on this episode. Also, all the footage that was shot in this episode was shot and edited by none other than PJ Mandeville, again, of Color Star Media. You guys check him out. I'll leave his information at the end of this video. But again, I just want to say thank you guys for tuning in to not just only this episode, but also last week's episode. If you haven't seen it, please go see it. It's on Instagram, it's on YouTube, Facebook. Just type in Wedding Videographer Docuseries. You'll definitely find it there.